presentation, Adam Mocco, St. Gregory the Theologian.
In the 11th century, a debate arose in Constantinople regarding which of the three saints, Basil the Great, John Chrysostom, and Gregory the Theologian, had surpassed the others in holiness and better explaining the mysteries of the faith. This dispute brought division and confusion into the church. So, one night, all three of the ecumenical teachers appeared before St. John Morvis in a dream, telling them they had no rivalry, and were all full of the same one Holy Spirit. They also told him to combine their feast days into one commemoration, as they were equal in the sight of the Lord. Because the people respected the saint, they agreed, establishing peace in the church again. We commemorate these three holy men on February 12th, old calendar. They were all brilliant and used that gift to teach others about God, which is why we acknowledge them in the church as the patron saints of education. Of the three saints is St. Gregory, the theologian, the holy man I will discuss today. Grace is given not to them who speak their faith, but to those who live by it. St. Gregory the Theologian. St. Gregory the Theologian, also known as St. Gregory of Nazianzus, is one of the greatest authors in the church. His writings covered many topics of Christianity, but he especially wrote on the Holy Trinity and defended it against Arianism. Known as the patron saint of poetry, St. Gregory's writings are some of the most majestic and eloquent in the church, which is why he's considered the most notable rhetorical stylist of the patristic age. St. Gregory was born into a pious Christian family in the year 329, with practically his whole family becoming saints, from his father Gregory to his mother Nona. His birth answered a prayer by his mother, who asked God for a son, vowing to dedicate him to the Lord, similar to the story of Prophet Samuel, Isaac, and John the Baptist. Even at a young age, Gregory was intrigued by the Holy Scriptures and studied Emerson's he could read. He received a religious, classical education, like all of us students at Padilla are receiving. And he sought to travel the world to gain knowledge from all his known globe, from Nazianzus to Caesarea, to Alexandria, and finally to Athens. However, on his way to Greece, Gregory encountered a great storm at sea that kept him from land for 20 days and nights. During that time, Gregory prayed to God with great fear despairing, as he had not been baptized. He promised to dedicate his life to the Almighty if God would save him. And after Gregory called upon the Lord's name, the storm subsided. Once he arrived in Athens, St. Gregory met his soon-to-be lifelong friend, St. Basil the Great, and the future Roman Emperor Julian. Gregory remained in Athens for 6 years, studying rhetoric, poetry, geometry, and astronomy. When Gregory returned in the year 358 to Nazianzus, at the age of 33, he was finally baptized by his father, who was bishop then. Later, against his will, Gregory was made a priest by his father. But when his father wanted to make his son a bishop, Gregory quickly left for Pontus, where his friend Basil had built a monastery. However, after his brother, St. Caesarius, died, Gregory returned home to aid his father in defending the church against heretics. Shortly after, St. Basil, Archbishop, consecrated St. Gregory as the bishop and allowed his friend to attend a church in Constantinople that was struggling against heresies. Although there were many more heretics than Orthodox Christians, such as Arians, Macedonians, and Apollinarians, Gregory defended the church with honor against the Goliath-like enemy that wanted to destroy the truth. And like how David defeated the giant, Gregory was converting people with every speech he uttered and every book he composed. In the year 380, Emperor Theodosius arrived in the capital and declared a decree that ended all heretics for now. The church had won, but not before Gregory's life was threatened by an assassin, who ended up repenting instead of murdering him. At the Second Ecumenical Council in the year 381, St. Gregory was chosen as the Patriarch of Constantinople. However, some bishops did not approve of this, as they were absent at the voting, and refused to acknowledge Gregory as their patriarch. Because of the problems that arose from this, St. Gregory quit his position as bishop, as he believed unity in the church to be more important than a title. He left Constantinople and became a solitary monk near Nazianzus. Our Holy Father died in the year 389 on January 25th, which is also when he is commemorated. St. Gregory continued to write letters, books, and poems on the Holy Trinity throughout his retirement. His angelic poems and heartfelt sermons are why many Christians became Orthodox in his time and ours today. We call St. Gregory the theologian because he is a person who knows God on a deep spiritual level teach others about him. The saint says this, "Knowledge of God does not come from studying philosophy or science, but from faith and prayer and living a pure life according to God's commandments." We as Christians should admire and yearn to be like St. Gregory, who lived a pure and holy life and is now among the saints with God in heaven.